Now on to our special report, and schools and colleges that promise success in competitive examinations, particularly those to get into the IITs, are big business in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. But what about their seamy underbelly behind posters of seemingly successful, smiling students? There are often countless students who suffer from low self-esteem, enormous pressure, and these institutes also boast of an alarmingly high rate of suicides. Uma Sudhir has this special report.
It is late in the evening, and like every day, students of Narayana School and Junior College in Vizag are sitting for after-school study hours. A routine day stretches from 5:30 in the morning to 11 in the night, all so that they can make it to the hallowed IIT club or some other prestigious engineering or medical college one day.
We'll get at 5 o'clock, that too the warden comes and go on shuts on the door like hell. It will be hell only. hell to hell. The morning, from morning 5 o'clock to night 11 o'clock, it will be hell only. My sister, she studied in particular college, MBBS. They will keeping on saying that you have 24 hours. 24 hours you should keep in your mind. Neat, NSAID. You have to crack it. You should not eat. You should not play with some other things. You have to have your books in your hand. You should go and read. That's it.
A sentiment echoed by almost every student in teaching shops like this one that have a single motto: success at competitive exams. This has not changed even after both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana governments issued serious warning and detailed advisory to all junior colleges, jolted into action after 50 students killed themselves in less than 2 months in the two states. Telangana's Deputy Chief Minister, who holds the education portfolio, has also threatened criminal cases against corporate colleges found to exert pressure on students for results. 194 colleges have already been issued notices. Even after that, incidents of students resorting to extreme steps are continuing. Just a few days ago, Navyashree cut her wrist after her mathematics teacher taunted her that she could die instead of faring so poorly in exams. Luckily, she survived, and her father begged her to book police case against the college.
Mentally, I was disturbed. Without saying to my parents, I have taken decision to die. Our principal madam gave total rights to jails. You can have the right to punish them. We want only the marks. We don't want anything.
There are hundreds like Navyashree who won't count in statistics that show one student suicide happens every 1 hour in the country. The National Crime Records Bureau figures show close to 40,000 students killed themselves between 2011 and 2015, nearly 9,000 students in 2015 alone. While everywhere students' stress levels are high, scores from board exams and various entrance tests determine college placements, career and social standing. What is peculiar in the corporate college culture of the Telugu states, as also places like Kota in Rajasthan, is that it has developed into a dark shadow education system where success is not about learning, but about cracking the entrance exams. Whatever it takes, and pressure is enormous. Many simply cannot cope.
States like Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Rajasthan, like Haryana and Sikkim also, these are the states that where more like coaching type of education is being given to children. These students are stressed and they are put into some kind of coaching centers, and they are compelled to come out with a kind of result.
What is ironic is that these colleges report huge success in competitive exams. In 2016-17, nearly 7,000 students from the Telugu states made it to IIT, NIIT and IIIT, the highest in the country. These successful faces become the poster boys and girls to lure fresh batches of students.
We are going to make your daughters or sons number one in our institution. Every parent will be listening that and simply blindly they'll go, they put some money, they invest some money on us. It's like that business only. They invest some money on us. If the business good perfectly runs, it runs perfectly, they're going to have the, they're going to achieve that. If not, it's our fault only.
There's a kind of caste system prevalent in such schools. If you're always on top of the class, getting top marks, then you are in the A grade class. But if you're not consistent and sometimes get poor marks, you are demoted to a B grade or a C grade class. That can be very depressing and demotivating for the students. Students say public humiliation is common, with verbal and physical abuse.
Behavior of the teachers makes a lot of difference. You know, in India, around 10 lakh students are preparing to appear for IIT and similarly NEET, NEET exam also. But why other states are not, we are experiencing this kind of incidents? Why only in Telugu state and Rajasthan? The majority of the students who really died, their economical background is not really good.
This young man, who is son of a labourer from Nalgunda district, jumped from the fifth floor, unable to carry the burden of expectations and performance. Activists point out that regulation has been a challenge. The schools are virtual monopolies with strong political connections. In Andhra Pradesh, for instance, out of nearly 10 lakh students, 70% are in private junior colleges, a majority of which are run by a group owned by Senior Minister Narayana. He stepped down as chairman after he joined the Naidu cabinet.
Private managements of the schools or colleges are not taking any, even a single instruction of the government education department, because the political entry is there. This education institute have become a very lucrative business, like real estate and others. Now real estate boom has gone and only boom is the education. In this education boom, every politician, irrespective of political ideologies, political affiliations, all the political parties, including the ruling party heads, are involved in the educational institutes.
There is a big fear of failure in exams, not able to live up to the expectations of parents, social pressure, long hours, public humiliation by the teachers, and no time at all to de-stress. These hostels have terrible conditions and there is no contact at all with the outer world. All these turn into a deadly cocktail for many young lives. The government has now said that every college must employ professional counselors, but the process has not even begun. In Hyderabad, with camera person Nagraju, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.